Short questions, short answers by Torah teacher Ariel and eBible. Copyright Tetze Torah Ministries 2015. All rights reserved. All right, here's the question we have for us. Why does God desire mercy and acknowledgement of Him instead of sacrifices? The verse reads, "For I desire steadfast love and not sacrifice, the knowledge of God rather than burnt offerings." That's Hosea 6, verse 6, ESV. In typical prophetic hyperbole, which is overstatements, even though at face value the verse seems to be saying that God wants mercy instead of sacrifices, I believe that God is actually telling His people that He does not want mercy instead of sacrifices, and He does not want sacrifices instead of mercy. He actually wants mercy plus sacrifices. You ready for this? Here we go. As long as a functioning temple was standing, God will always desire mercy plus sacrifices. Why? Because sacrifices often accompany making physical restitution between you and your fellow man. Let me explain. Look at this quote from GodQuestions.org. Leviticus 6, 2 through 5 covers other situations in which the stolen property is restored plus one-fifth of the value. Also of note, in this passage, the restitution was made to the owner of the property, not to the government or any other third party. And the compensation was to be accompanied by a guilt offering to the Lord. The Mosaic Law then protected victims of theft, extortion, fraud, and negligence by requiring the offending parties to make restitution. The amount of remuneration varied anywhere from 100 to 500% of the loss. That's from GodQuestions.org. Very great website, by the way. So notice what they're trying to explain about the sacrifices and what else was to be brought. They go on to say the restitution was to be made on the same day that the guilty one brought the sacrifice before the Lord, which implies that making amends with one's neighbor is just as important as making peace with God through the sacrificial system. Making sense? Okay. So we've got a sacrificial system, and we've got David. Psalm 51, 14 through 19 is David's prayer to have mercy on him and to restore him after his gross sin with Bathsheba. He's our example for tonight. It reads, "Deliver me from blood guiltiness, O God of my salvation, and my tongue will sing aloud of your righteousness. O Lord, open my lips, and my mouth will declare your praise." So we're looking at David as our example of bringing sacrifices. "For you will not delight in sacrifice, or I would give it. You will not be pleased with a burnt offering. The sacrifices of God are a broken spirit, a broken and contrite heart, O God, you will not despise." These are very familiar words, but look at the context. "Do good to Zion in your good pleasure. Build up the walls of Jerusalem. Then you will delight in right sacrifices, in burnt offerings and whole burnt offerings. Then bulls will be offered on your altar." Wait a minute. Notice firstly that David recognizes that mere mechanical sacrifice participation is not what God desires. Psalm 51:16, "For you will not delight in sacrifice, or I would give it. You will not be pleased with a burnt offering." What's the context? Is David saying that God's prescribed system of sacrifices is worthless in regards to repentance and restoration? No, not really. Indeed, David recognizes that what God truly wants is a heart poured out in genuine repentance. Psalm 51:17, "The sacrifices of God are a broken spirit, a broken and contrite heart. O God, you will not despise." That's the context. The reason we know that God desires mercy and sacrifices is because David goes on to assure us that God wants them both. Let's look at the verse one more time in case you missed it. Psalm 51:18-19, "Then you will delight in right sacrifices, in burnt offerings and whole burnt offerings. Then bulls will be offered on your altar." This is, of course, after he talks about the broken and the contrite heart. So, what are our conclusions to tonight's study? Here they are. Next time you see a prophet rebuking Israel for bringing sacrifices like Hosea 6, 6 or Isaiah 1, 11 through 15, just know that there is nothing wrong with what they are doing by bringing sacrifices per se. Rather, it's what is in the heart that God is looking at. God hates hypocrisy. Why bring sacrifices if you're going to continue sinning against your fellow man, right? That's the whole point. I essentially see the same principle demonstrated in Matthew 5, 23 and 24. Here, Yeshua tells the crowd to reconcile to your brother, plus bring your offering to the altar. Did you guys notice that? God isn't asking for reconciliation instead of your offering. He delights in reconciliation plus your offering. That's the way we understand the way the system was set up. Mercy plus sacrifices is what God desires. And this accords with God's gracious Torah, the law, that places value on both. It is important to note that the qualification of a proper heart attitude is clearly implied in Leviticus 16, 29 and 31, where the people are asked to afflict their soul. The KJV has the word afflict there for the Hebrew anah. Afflict your souls. Accordingly, only those who had inwardly prepared their hearts were eligible to receive the gracious gift of God's forgiveness. Make sense? I hope that makes sense for you. Check out my podcasts, which are available on iTunes. You can search for me in the store under the search term Ariel HaNavi. But if you prefer to watch your theology, check out my YouTube channel. Subscribe to my YouTube channel and click the bell for notifications. New content is added weekly or even daily.